Com, this is to one and all. Myself, my name is Sai Kiran. I am Maths faculty in Pelamala IIT Foundation. Today's our topic is problems on distance formula and section formula and midpoint formula. Okay, they are given one of the problem. Find the distance between the point cos theta comma sin theta and minus sin theta comma cos theta. Just here ones of the they are given. Okay, nothing but line segment joining the point they are given. First question. Line segment joining the point they are given. Okay, this is cos theta and this is minus sin theta comma cos theta. Okay, just see here one of the okay, this is another point, let it be A, and this is another point, let it be B. Okay, two points they are given, we want to find the distance formula. When you know the two points they are given, that is nothing but we are treated as x1 comma y1. Okay, this is x2 comma y2. We want to find the distance. What is distance formula? Distance AB is equal to square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. Okay, just substitute that formula. Just here we can read that this is x1, x2 and this is x1. Just substitute that what you are getting. Square root of x2 means minus sin theta minus cos theta whole square plus y2 means cos theta minus sin theta, y1 means sin theta whole square. Okay, just here once of the okay, when you take a minus here, when you take in these two minus, we can take common. When we are taking the minus is common. Minus of whole square means positive. That means it is nothing but sin theta plus cos theta whole square plus here it is nothing but cos theta minus sin theta whole square. Okay. Just here once of the this is sin theta plus cos theta whole square or cos theta plus sin theta whole square. Both are same. You see, just here once of the a plus b whole square is equal to what we can write? A square plus B square plus 2AB. Okay, in the same way, A minus B whole square is equal to what we can write? A square plus B square minus 2AB. When you add these two, it means nothing but A plus B whole square plus A minus B whole square, which is equal to these two cancel, then we are getting 2A square plus 2b square. That is nothing but when you take the 2 is common, then a square plus b square we are getting. Okay, just here once of the a plus b whole square plus a minus b whole square is equal to what we can write? 2 into a square plus b square. In the same way, just here once of the cos theta plus sin theta whole square plus cos theta minus sin theta whole square. A plus b whole square plus a minus b whole square. Means what we can write? That means square root of 2 into sin square theta plus cos square theta. Okay, that is nothing but here this is nothing but one of the trigonometric identity. Sin square theta plus cos square theta value is 1. That means what we can get? Square root of 2 into 1. That is nothing but square root 2. Okay, the distance between cos theta comma sin, point cos theta comma sin theta and minus sin theta comma cos theta is root 2 units. Okay, in the same way, observe second question. What is they are given? Second question. Find the perimeter of a triangle formed by the points. They are given three points: 0, 0, and 1, 0, and 0, 1. Okay, they are given three points. Just here once of the when you plot these points, it will become somewhat easy. See here once of the when you take a coordinate system, Cartesian plane, nothing but 0, 0 means origin. Here it is 0, 0. Next, 1, 0 means 1, 0 means it is lies on x-axis. X-axis means 1, 0. For example, this is 1, 0. Okay, it is how much distance means 1 unit. Okay, next 0, 1 means nothing but here it is the point. Okay, this is lies on y-axis. Okay, here also it is 1 unit. When you join these three points. It will form a right angle triangle. Okay, already here we know distance between these two is 1 unit, distance between these two is 1 unit. We want to find the distance between these two. Or nothing but we can apply directly Pythagoras theorem. What is Pythagoras theorem? Hypotenuse square is equal to side square plus side square. Hypotenuse square is equal to, here let it be, this is x. X square is equal to side square, 1 square plus 1 square. That means x square is equal to 1 plus 1. That is x square is equal to 2. X is equal to square root 2. Square root 2 units. That means this is nothing but root 2 units. We want to find the perimeter. Perimeter means sum of all sides. Sum of all sides. Perimeter is equal to. Perimeter is equal to sum of all sides means 1 plus root 2. That is 2 plus root 2 units. Okay. In generally we can do like this. Okay. We want to. They are given. Okay. We don't know. Okay, this form a right angle triangle or not, we don't know that. Okay, we are taking in generally triangle. Okay, in generally triangle we are taking, this is 0, 0. Okay, this is 1, 0. This is 0, 1 we are taking. Okay, we want to find the perimeter means just we need to find the distance between these two is nothing but this side length. Okay, when you find the distance between these two means nothing but just here once the distance from origin only. Okay, here from point to origin, distance from origin is square root of x1 square plus y1 square. That is nothing but we are getting 1. Okay, in the same way, distance between these two we can find is same way 1 we are getting. In the same way, we can find the distance between these two we are getting the root 2. In the same way, perimeter means sum of all sides. Okay, we can get the answer. Okay, perimeter is equal to what we can get means sum of all sides. Sum of all sides means 1 plus root 2. That is 2 plus root 2 units. Okay, perimeter of a triangle formed by the points 0, 0 and 1, 0. 0, 1 is 2 plus root 2 units. Okay, when you take a root 2 is common, sometimes they will give option like this also. When you take a root 2 is common, root 2 plus 1 units. Okay, you can observe the example. Okay, first we can do fourth example. This is easy. Okay, image of a point 3, 6 under the x axis and y axis under origin. Image of a point, okay, already we know x comma y is a point, image, okay, under x axis, under x axis means we need to change the sign of y coordinate. That is nothing but what is image of a point under x axis, nothing but x comma minus y. That means here 3 comma 6 is the point, image under x axis means what is that point means 3 comma minus 6. Okay, under y axis, what we can get means we need to change the sign of x coordinate. That means minus x comma y. That is nothing but what is the point means minus 3 comma 6. In the same way under origin. Under origin means we need to change the sign of both. That is nothing but minus x comma minus y. Here the point is 3 comma 6 means under origin. What we can get means minus 3 comma minus 6. Just here once of the image of a point 3 comma 6 under x axis means we need to change the sign of y coordinate. That means 3 comma minus 6. Okay, under y axis means we need to change the sign of x coordinate. That means we can get minus 3 comma 6. Under origin means we need to change the both the sign. Both the sign means minus 3 comma minus 6. Okay, next we can observe the third one here. Okay, they are given a point is 8t square comma 2at and capital B point a by t square comma minus 2a by t and s point is given. Then they are asking 1 by sa plus 1 by sb. Okay, what is sa means distance between the point s to a. Okay, we want to find the distance between the point sa. Okay, first we can find sa. Okay, they are given the points. What are the points are given? At square 2at. B point is, what is B point is a by t square comma 2a by t and s point is a comma 0. Just here once of the we want to find the distance between the points sa. Okay, this is let it be x1 and y1. Let it be this is x2 and y2. Or this is x1 y1 and this is x2 y2. You can take no problem. Both are same only. Okay, what is distance for now means square root of x2 minus x1. X2 minus x1 means a minus x1 means a t square whole square plus y2 minus y1. Y2 minus y1 means 0 minus 2 a t1 whole square. Okay, when you simplify this one, what you are getting? Just here one to the square root of a minus a t square whole square plus. Okay, when you simplify this one, means what we are getting is 4 a square t square. Okay. When you write this one in the form of like this, okay, a minus a t square whole square plus 2 into, sorry, 4 into a t square. Okay, just when you simplify this one, we are getting 4 a into a t square means a square into t square we are can get. Just here one of the, it is nothing but, okay, when you write a minus b whole square plus 4a, just here one of the, this is a, this full can be treated as b. Okay, a minus b whole square plus 4ab. A minus b whole square plus 4ab is nothing but a plus b whole square. A plus b whole square. That means what you can get means square root of a plus a t square whole square. Square root become cancelled, then what you are getting means a plus a t square can get. Okay. In the same way, just here once again observe. Okay. We want to find sb. What is sb means? In the same way, just here we can treat as this is x1 comma y1. Okay, when you simplify this one, what you can get? X2 minus x1, a minus a t square whole square plus y2 minus y1. Same way, 0 minus of minus plus 2a by t whole square. When you simplify this one, what you can get? Square root of a minus a by t square whole square. Plus here also what you can get? 4 a square by t square. Same way, what you can write? Square root of here a minus a by t square whole square. This one I am writing 4 into a by t square I am writing. Just same way. A minus b whole square plus 4ab means what you can write? Okay, a plus b whole square. That means what you can write means just a square root of a plus a by t square whole square. Okay, square root cancel, then what you are getting means a plus a by t square you can get. Okay, when you take the LCM, then what you are getting means a t square plus a by t square. Okay, just here one of the SB value we are getting, SA value we are getting. Okay, we want to find 1 by SA plus 1 by SB. Okay, can I do it here? We'll rough here and I do. Okay, just here what's the 1 by, sorry. Okay, 1 by SA plus 1 by SB. Okay, 1 by SA means what you are getting? A plus A by T square. Sorry, A T square. Plus 1 by SB. SB means what you are getting? Okay, A T square plus A whole by T square. Okay, when it will go to the numerator, it will be reciprocal, then what you are getting means? Okay, 1 by A plus A T square by t square by a plus a t square you can get. When you take the LCM, a plus a t square, then what you are getting means 1 plus t square by a plus a t square. Okay, when you observe the denominator a is common, when you take the a is common, then what you are getting means 1 plus t square by a we can take common, means what you are getting? 1 plus t square. When you cancel these two, what you are getting means 1 by a. That means 1 by SA plus 1 by SB is equal to 1 by A we can get. We can observe the next example. Find the length of median through A of a triangle whose vertices are A 1 comma 3 minus 1 comma 3, B 1 comma minus 1 and C 5 comma 1. Okay, they are given 3 vertices of a triangle. Okay, we can take a triangle. Here it is, triangle ABC. This is A, this is B and this is C. a vertex is minus 1 comma 3 and b vertex is 1 comma minus 1 and c vertex is 5 comma 1. Okay, just here on the we want to find the length of median through a. What is median? Okay, what is median means? Okay, just here on the line segment drawn from one vertex to any one vertex to opposite side midpoint. For example, here, for example, we are taking a vertex. Okay, a line segment drawn from one vertex to opposite side midpoint. That means midpoint of BC is okay, some d. Okay, then whenever these two sides are equal, sorry, these two lengths are equal, then d is midpoint. Okay, we want line segment drawn from one vertex to opposite side midpoint. That means here this line segment is we can call it as median. What is meant by median means what we can say? A line segment drawn from one vertex to opposite side midpoint. That means D is nothing but midpoint of BC. Okay, we want to find the midpoint of BC, that is D point we can get. Okay, then we have to find the distance between the points A and D, that is length of median. Okay, just here once of the first we need to find the D point. D is nothing but midpoint of BC. Okay, what is midpoint formula means? Midpoint formula what we can write? Okay, whenever this is x1 comma y1, this is x2 comma y2, what is midpoint formula means? X1 plus x2 by 2 comma y1 plus y2 by 2. Okay, just we can apply that formula, just x1 plus x2. Okay, x1 plus x2 means 1 plus 5 by 2 comma y1 plus y2 minus 1 plus 1 by 2. Okay, when you simplify this one, 6 by 2 comma minus 2 by 2, that is nothing but 3 comma, sorry, this is 0, minus 1 and plus 1 cancel, then we can get 0. Okay, 3 comma 0 by anything is 0, that means 3 comma 0. D point we are getting 3 comma 0, this point is 3 comma 0. We want to find the length of median through A. Length of median through A means AD. Okay, length of median through B means B to A, sorry, B opposite of side midpoint we need to find, then we can find that median. Okay, we want to find the distance between AD. Okay, that is distance AD. Distance AD. Just here once of the we want to find the distance. What is distance formula means? Okay, just here once of the whenever. Okay, this is x1, y1. Okay, this is x2, y2. Okay, we want to find the distance formula means square root of x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. That means just we can apply that formula, distance is equal to square root of x2. X2 means 3 minus half minus 1 whole square plus y2 minus y1. Y2 means 0 minus 3 whole square. Just when you simplify this one, okay, minus half minus plus 3 plus 1 is 4, 4 square plus okay, minus 3 whole square. Just when you simplify this one, 4 square means 16 plus minus 3 whole square means 9. Okay, square root of 25, square root of 25 value is 5 units. That means just here once of the we want to find the length of a median through A means A to D distance. A to D distance is 5 units. That means length of median is 5 units. So the next example, find the point which divides the line segment joining the points A plus B comma A minus B and A minus B comma A plus B in the ratio A is to B. Okay, whenever they are given this one, nothing but whenever they are not mentioned anything internally or externally, we need to take internally only. Okay, in the ratio, okay, one of the point here, some point of P which divides in the ratio A is to B, they are given. We want to find this point of P x comma y. Okay, this is some A point, we can treat as this is some B point. Okay, let it be this is x1 comma y1, this is x2 comma y2. Okay, P divides line segment joining the points A and B in the ratio A is to B. Okay, that is nothing but section formula we can use. What is section formula P x comma y? Internally we are using internally. What is formula means? M in the ratio M is to N means what is formula means? MX2 plus NX1 by m plus n, comma m by 2 plus n by 1 by m plus n. In the place of m is to n, here they are given a is to b. That means what you can write? A. M means a. X2. X2 means a minus b plus n. N means b into x1. X1 means a plus b by m plus n. That is a plus b comma m by 2. M by 2 means a into a plus b plus n. N into means b into y1. Y1 means a minus b by, okay, a plus b. Fine, you simplify this one. Okay, when you multiply a here inside, a square minus ab plus, okay, when you multiply here, ab plus b square by a plus b, comma, when you multiply here, a square plus ab, okay, when you multiply here, ab minus b square by a plus b. Okay, when you simplify this one, okay, ab cancels, then what you are getting? A square plus b square by a plus b, comma, okay, when you simplify this one, a square plus 2ab minus b square by a plus b. Okay, this is the point p x comma y. That means this point divides line segment joining the points a and b in the ratio a is to b. What is that point means? A plus a square plus b square by a plus b, comma, a square plus 2ab minus b square by a plus b. Okay, next we can observe the example. If 1 comma 2 and 4 comma 3 and 6 comma 4 are the midpoints of sides of sides BC and AC and AB of triangle ABC, then A vertex. Okay, just here once of the, they are given 7th question. Triangle ABC, they are given ABC. Okay. 1 comma 2 is midpoint of BC. This is 1 comma 2 midpoint. 1 comma 2, let it be D. Okay, this is midpoint. Okay, next. 4 comma 3 is midpoint of AC. This is midpoint here. This is 4 comma 3. Okay, let it be, this is E. Okay, next. 6 comma 4 is midpoint. Okay, 6 comma 4 is midpoint of AB. 6 comma 4, let it be F. Okay. This is midpoint. Okay. Then they are asking A vertex. Okay. Already we told a not point. Okay. D, E, F are the midpoints of triangle ABC. We want to find any vertex. Okay. Then it will form a parallelogram. When you join these are all. Okay. When you join these are all. Okay. By using a midpoint theorem and when you observe. Okay. A, F, D is a parallelogram. A, F, D is a parallelogram. We want to A vertex. A vertex means what you can write? A is equal to F plus E minus D. F plus E. Okay, we can observe the X coordinates. F plus E. That means 6 plus 4. 6 plus 4 minus D. Minus 1, comma Y coordinate. 4 plus 3 minus 2. When you simplify this one, 6 plus 4 is 10. 10 minus 1 is 9, comma 4 plus 3 is 7, 7 minus 2 is 5. That means A vertex is 9 comma 5. In the same way, they are asking B vertex means D plus F minus E we can do. D plus F minus E means 6 plus 1, 7, 7 minus 3. That is B vertex. Okay, 6 plus 1, 7, 7 minus 4, 3. Okay, 4 plus 2, 6, 6 minus 3, 3. That means B vertex is 3 comma 3. In the same way, C vertex they are asking means what you can do? Okay, C vertex we want. Okay, D plus E minus F or E plus D minus F. Okay, 1 plus 4, 5. 5 minus 6, minus 1, comma 2 plus 3, 5. 5 minus 4, 1. Okay, that means C vertex is minus 1, comma 1. Okay, in the same way, next we can observe. Next we can observe 8th question. What is there given means? 2 comma 3 divide the line segment joining the points 5 comma 6 and 8 comma 9. Okay, joining the points they are given. Okay, one of the point is here 5 comma 6, another point is 8 comma 9. Okay, let it be, this is A and this is B. Some point P here, what is that point means? 2 comma 3. Okay, the point P divides Okay, here this is x1 comma y1, this is x2 comma y2. Okay, the point x comma y divides. We have a dot point. Okay, the point x comma y divides the line segment joining the points x1 comma y1 and x2 comma y2. What is ratio formula? Okay, whenever three points they are given, okay, we have to find the ratio formula is either x1 minus x is to x minus x2, or okay, y1 minus y is to y minus y2. We can use any one of the formula, you can get answer. Okay, I'll use x coordinates. X1, x1 means 5 minus 2 is to 2 minus 8. That is nothing but, okay, 3 is to, okay, minus 6. 3 is to minus 6 means 1 is to minus 2. That is nothing but 1 is to 2 externally. Okay, when you use the same formula in y coordinates also, we can get the same answer. That means 1 is to 2 externally. That means this point divides, okay, the line segment joining the points in the ratio 1 is to 2 externally. That means this is external point. External point. Okay. We can observe the next example. If the midpoint of x comma y plus 1 and x plus 1 comma y plus 2 is 3 by 2 comma 5 by 2, then we have to find the midpoint of x minus 1 comma y plus 1 and x plus 1 comma y minus 1. Okay. Just here one, when you simplify this one, midpoint of this one. Okay, or directly we can use this one also, no problem. Okay, midpoint formula, when you treat that, this is x1 and y1, this is x2 and y2. Okay, then what is midpoint formula means? X1 plus x2, x1 means x plus, x2 means x plus 1 by 2, comma y1 plus y2, y1 plus y, y1 means y plus 1 plus y2 means y plus 2 by 2. Okay, they are given already midpoint, how much means 3 by 2 comma 5 by 2. When you simplify this one, okay, x plus x, 2x plus 1 by 2 comma, okay, y plus y, 2y plus 1 plus 2, 3 by 2 is equal to 3 by 2 comma 5 by 2. Okay, when you simplify this one, whenever the two order pairs are equal, that means first coordinate is equal to first coordinate, second coordinate is equal to second coordinate. That means when you simplify, 2x plus 1 by 2 is equal to 3 by 2 and 2y plus 3 by 2 is equal to 5 by 2. Okay, when you simplify this one, 2, 2 cancel, here also 2, 2 cancel. That means 2x is equal to plus 1, we'll send to that side, means minus, then it will become 2. Then when you simplify this one, 2 by 2 we can get, 2 by 2 means 1. That means x is equal to 1 we are getting. And the same way here also, 2y is equal to plus 3 will send to that side, means minus, then it will become 2. Then y is equal to what we are getting means 2 by 2, that is nothing but 1. Y is equal to also 1. Then we have to find the midpoint of this one. Okay, we want to find the midpoint of this one. Just we can say midpoint. Okay, just we can substitute x value r. Okay, just we can simplify that one. Then what we are getting, we can observe x1, this is x1, y1, this is x2, y2. X1 plus x2, x1 plus x2 means x minus 1 plus x plus 1 by 2 comma y1 plus y2, y1 plus y2 means y plus 1 plus y minus 1 by 2. When you simplify this one, minus 1 plus 1 cancel, and here also minus 1 plus 1 cancel. X plus x, 2x, 2x by 2 means x we are getting, and y plus y, 2y by 2 we can get y. That means a midpoint of these two points is nothing but x comma y. What is x comma y means 1 comma 1. That means 1 comma 1. Midpoint of these two points is nothing but 1 comma. Okay, now we can observe the next example. Okay, one of the important one, the point whose coordinates are x is equal to x1 plus t into x2 minus x1 and y is equal to y1 plus t into y2 minus y1, divide the join of points x1 comma y1 and x2 comma y2 in the ratio. Okay, they are given line segment joining the points. Line segment joining the points, this is x1 comma y1, this is x2 comma y2. Okay, one other point, okay, here the P point, this is, let it be A and this is B. And some P point, what is P point means? X1 coordinates are given the P point x1 plus okay, t into x2 minus x1, comma, y coordinate is y1 plus t into y2 minus y1. Okay, they are asking the ratio. Okay, just here once of the p x comma y, let it be this is x comma y. Okay, p x comma y, divide the line segment joining the points x1 comma y1 and x2 comma y2. We have a ratio formula. What is ratio formula means? X1 minus x is to x minus x2. Just we can simplify this one. X1 means here, x1 only minus x1, x means this one minus half means minus x1 minus half t into x2 minus x1. When you multiply with the minus here, minus x1 minus t into x2 minus x1 is to just x, x means x, x1 plus t into x2 minus x1 minus x2. X2 means x2 only. Okay, just here once of the, okay, x1, x1 cancel, then what you are getting? Minus t into x2 minus x1, okay, is to, okay, x1 minus x2, okay, x1 minus x2. When you take a minus is common here, when you take a, for these two minus is common, when you take a minus is common, then x2 become positive and x1 become negative, plus t into x2 minus x1. Okay, just here one of the minus t is to, minus t is to, okay, for these two, sorry, minus t into x2 minus x1, okay, division ratio is nothing but a division, we can write the division form. Okay, when you take the x2 minus x1 is common, x2 minus x1 is common, when you take the x2 minus x1 is common, here plus t is left, here minus 1 is left, then these two become cancelled, okay. They are given, what you can get means minus t by minus t minus 1. Okay, sometimes they give the ratio, okay, minus we can multiply with the denominator, then what you can get means t by 1 minus t also. Okay, okay, that means the ratio is t is to 1 minus t. The ratio is t is to 1 minus t, we can say, or we can say the ratio is minus t by t minus 1. Okay, so same question they'll give, and they will say, okay, the point, this point divides internally, okay, the point divides internally, then what is the t values lies between, what are the t values lies between, just here once of the, whenever, okay, it divides internally, that means ratio must be positive, ratio must be positive, just here once of the, what are the values we can take here, it must be positive, that means we can take t values, in between 0 and 1, in between 0 and 1, for example, if you take a 0 below, that means negative, t value negative we can take means, it will become negative, okay, here minus half, that means negative number means positive, then total it is positive, that means negative by positive is negative we can get, that means ratio is negative, it never be negative, why, because, okay, we are saying internal division. Okay, if we are taking in t values 0 and 1 in between, 0 and 1 in between, okay, 0 and 1 between we can take, in between means 0.5 we can take, okay, 0.5 is positive, 1 minus 0.5 is positive, positive by positive is positive, we can get, that means it is internal division possible. If you are taking 1 above, if you are taking 1 above, what is happen? 1 above means 2 we can take, 2 by 1 minus 2, that means a minus 1, here it is positive, it will become negative, that means ratio is negative. That means whenever, okay, the point divides internally, okay, sometimes they'll ask same question, this point divides internally, then what is the t condition? T condition means 0 less than t less than 1. Okay, they are asking directly now ratio, what is ratio means t by 1 minus t we can write, or minus t by t minus 1 we can write. Okay, okay, in the same way they are asking, okay, whenever the point is externally, whenever the point is externally, that means except this one, except these points, that means 0 below and 1 above, 0 below and 1 above we can take means we can get a negative ratio only, negative ratio means then it will become external division. Thank you.